Hi there, my name is Toby and this is Body Efficiency Training, and in this video I want to continue talking about healing and the life force energy. You see, we've been given a particular idea about how the body works and how we have to heal ourselves, and it's a false idea, put it bluntly. Our science has only got half of the picture. We base our science on materialism. We've broken everything down into mechanics, and we have totally dismissed the life force energy itself. So we're never looking at the life force, we're never thinking about the life force, we're only thinking about the after effects, the mechanics that appear after the effect of the life force itself. So we've got to readdress this problem, and in the last couple of videos I've talked about it, and I've had some tooth pain, so it's very relevant to me right now. I'm in the process of healing myself from a fairly severe problem, and the other night I was up all night in pain. I couldn't fix the pain, and I do have a fracture in the tooth for many years, and I've managed to keep it at bay, so I thought, okay, finally I might have to deal with this now. The first dentist I went to said, okay, we've got to drill it or pull it. And I thought, well, that's not right, because the x-ray looked fine. So I went back to my old dentist, who did the same thing, x-rayed, and said, well, no, nothing wrong with the tooth, just an infection. Here's some antibiotics. So this leads me to what I want to talk about now is, okay, so I've got a bacterial infection. These bacteria are attacking me and trying to damage me on the inside, and I've got to fight this back. Now, this idea is false. We've been given the idea that we are under attack. We've got these microorganisms coming at us from all angles, and they just want to kill us. They want to get rid of us, and there's nothing much we can do, so we better just shrivel up and go and live in a corner, don't breathe any air in case any of them get us. So this creates a particular state of mind. We're living in high fear, high stress, and this weakens our mind, body, spirit. It weakens us dramatically. So this is an attitude that we've been given that is false, but it keeps us in check. It keeps us small, it keeps us weak, and we're more susceptible to illness in this state of mind. So what's really going on? Are these bacteria there to kill me? No, they are not. Now, the easiest way to say it is this: a bacteria are more like vultures. They are not predators, they are vultures. Now, vultures, we don't like them, but they serve a very good purpose. They come in and clear up. See, it's all about balance and imbalance. When an imbalance occurs, something comes in to readdress that and bring back balance. Ultimately, the universe is about harmony. It's about symbiosis, cooperation. Everything works together in a wonderful harmony based on this life force energy. The idea we've been given is that everything is at war. We're fighting. It's survival of the fittest. You can never relax. Okay, you're always under attack. Now, this puts you in a weakened state. Now, I want to give you a couple of other thoughts. This is true, okay? It shows you the effect of the mind and body. This story goes back to the 70s. There was a guy who was working on a train, and one of the carts was a freezer cart. So he got stuck in this freezer cart overnight, and he's banging on the door, he can't get out, and he thinks, okay, now I'm going to die. I'm in this freezer cart, I can't get out. So he writes on the wall, these may be my last words. I'm stuck here, I'm getting colder, I'm getting colder. And then eventually that was it. They found him the next morning, he was dead, and those were his last words. But interestingly, that freezer was broken. There was no freezing happening. The temperature inside never dropped below outside temperature. The guy just believed he was freezing to death, and he froze to death. You've got to understand the power of the mind-body connection. If you are given a belief that you're under attack, now you're put into a state of mind that is weakening your body. It's nonsense. These bacteria are my friends. I love them. They've come in. They're cleaners. They come to help me clean up a mess. It's not the same as a predator coming to harm me. And there's viruses the same. We don't have to think about them either, but viruses are another story, which I'll go into more detail. But if you're interested, you've got to look up terrain theory and germ theory. And in fact, germ theory was disproved over 100 years ago or so. But the germ theory was propagated because it's much easier to make a profit. So terrain theory is more like the Eastern philosophy. It's more to do with your environment. Sickness is to do with imbalance in the environment and how it affects your balance. And so healing is about rebalancing yourself. It's not about a fight. It's about rebalancing. Now, in a couple of videos before, I talked about chi and life forces fighting for your life. Now, we want that fighting spirit, the warrior spirit. But the deepest understanding of this all is an acceptance. You just accept it, because the universe is all about harmony. And if you can achieve harmony, this is the ultimate healing. So see yourself in perfect health. This is the key. See yourself in perfect harmony. Whatever is going on, you try to rebalance it. Don't fight it, rebalance it. That means you make adjustments in your life. So I've got to fix my tooth. I'm sending the chi in that area, but I'm loving that area. I'm loving the bacteria. I'm sending them loving energy. I'm saying, thank you for helping me clear this up, but I don't need your services anymore. I'm now fixing this myself. You see, you can watch this in a petri dish. If you have a healthy cell, the bacteria leave it alone. Only when that cell starts dying by itself and the cell membrane starts to collapse, then the bacteria come in. You see, they are vultures, not predators. And vultures are a useful thing. The same in the garden. The garden gets out of balance. The slugs come in. The snails come in. They're trying to clean up an imbalance in the minerals. So everything is about balance and harmony, and we do that by breathing our chi into the belly, harmonizing our body, trying to achieve a good alignment in the body. That's the first thing, balance left and right, balance up and down, and then try and integrate your mind body together and see yourself in perfect health, living in harmony. You're not at war, you are at peace. So now, given what I've been saying, the question is, am I going to take the antibiotics given to me by the dentist? And it's a question I'm still puzzling. You see, I've given myself some time to see if I can fix this myself, and it seems to be getting better. But if it doesn't, then I probably will give it a go. Now, why? Well, the attitude we've got to have is not that these are predators chasing us down, but vultures. You can imagine vultures get carried away. Too many vultures turn up. And a vulture won't wait for an animal to die. They're still going to start. They see a wounded animal, they're going to start at it and they'll kill it. But they won't go and attack a healthy animal. They'll only look at one that's already dying. And it's the same with us. If we've got too many vultures, we might need to scare them off, you know, get rid of them. But it's not the same attitude as, hey, these are deadly predators hunting us down. This is more like, I've got to be a scarecrow. Go, shoo, shoo, too many of you. Get going now. So we might need a bit of help to get rid of them. Now, the first thing I do is always take natural remedies. So I've got a natural antibiotic, and it's called Citricidal. Now, I haven't bought this for a while. I've got it a long time ago. You can look it up. I'll mention it below in the description so you can check it out. So I always start with that straight away. And if that doesn't work, and I take a lot of it, more than they say, I take plenty of it. And if that doesn't work, then I'll take the stronger stuff if I have to. But I understand if I take the normal antibiotics, they're quite potent and they kill too many things in your body that they don't have to. They're not refined enough. But we have to take what we've got. The medical system we've got is there. We have to use it. But we try and use it as little as possible. You see, I'm complaining about the medical system, but it's all we've got, or it's all that is available to us. All I want to say is we could have so much better. And advanced medicine is not difficult. We had it a long time ago, and we just got rid of it. And I'll talk about advanced medical treatments in a minute. But we've got to use what we've got. And if we've got these antibiotics, okay, well, at least it's going to kill off the extra bacteria, and it's going to kill off a bit of stuff in me as well. So I've got to compensate by taking a lot of probiotics and make sure I regrow my microbiome. But I do that anyway. I drink kefir. I make my own kefir, water kefir, milk kefir, have yogurt, cheese, all sorts of bacteria. I'm always eating those to feed the microbiome. It's very important. And I also take some supplements, but I've done a long, long research on different supplements, and I only take a few now. But one of the ones I take for your teeth is called pearl powder. And again, I'll link below. But pearl powder is just ground up freshwater pearls, and the minerals in there are so close to your teeth. They even used to use pearls as replacement teeth because they're so close to teeth. So the minerals in that are very good for your teeth and your eyes and your overall health. So pearl powder and Citricidal, the two that I'm taking now, with a few other little bits and bobs. But it's still not over, and I still haven't made the final decision, but so far I have not taken the antibiotics. I've only taken my natural remedies, but I'm keeping a careful eye on myself. You see, I don't go into denial. I'm concentrating on my healing, seeing myself in perfect health, but I don't go into denial. I also got to face reality. It's a delicate balance, a delicate balance. You see, we need both the fighting spirit, yes, I'm fighting for my life, and we need the equanimity, the harmony. Yeah, we want to achieve balance and harmony. And this is the ultimate healing. But both of these things are actually the same thing. If you think about balance, balance requires a center. You've got to find your center, and you're always trying to get back to your center. You see, always knocked off balance. Balance is highly dynamic. Balance is not static. We see someone balancing on one leg, we think, oh, they're very still. They're not. When you're balancing on one leg, you're making continuous adjustments. You're always fighting for that balance. So balance, to achieve this harmony and balance, you've got to fight for it. So now we bring the two together. You need the warrior spirit to find your core, your center, and fight for that. Hold it. Hold that point of balance. And when you're out of balance, you're trying to find it again. So you need the warrior spirit to find your balance, find your integrity. Yep, this is me. This is what I'm doing. I am healing. Yes, I'm going to heal myself. That warrior spirit. Well, how do I heal myself? I'm going to find harmony. I'm going to find balance. Yes. So I'm using my warrior spirit to find balance. This is the key. And this is yin and yang together. You see the warrior spirit, you can think of it as the yang, and the yin is that harmony, that peace, that equanimity. But we need both the yin and the yang. And the other thing I want to talk about is very interesting. So I'm fighting a bacterial infection, or I'm trying to rebalance from a bacteria overload. That's another way of saying it. And what happens is you tend to go into a fever. So I did have a swelling. I noticed after the first dentist, he bashed my tooth around an awful lot. And it seemed to get better for some reason. I thought maybe he'd healed my tooth by bashing it around. The pain sort of subsided. But then it sort of went around and I felt a swelling. I thought, okay, maybe he's bruised it up a bit. But of course, that's the infection is creating a swelling in there. But you also get a fever. You know, you feel aches and pains when you're fighting an infection. It's bacterial overload. You get these aches and pains and you go into a delirium. A fever is sort of a delirium. And this is an altered state. You're going into an altered state of mind. You're going into a state where your mind and body are coming together. And you can look at this as a chi state, a state of chi, or a shamanic state. You're going into a shamanic state. You're going into a dream, into the delirium. And you see, in a real severe fever, you know, you have hallucinations. You've gone way into a psychedelic experience. And what's happening here? You're actually going into a state of healing. And this is what a shaman does. This is the ultimate healer of the olden days. A shaman goes into this altered state, and from this altered state they're feeling the energy and they do what is required. So in a fever we're entering into a shamanic journey, is what they call it, a journey. You're going into an experience, but it's an experience of your chi. Your mind and body have come together. They're not separate. You have to be in your body because you're feeling these aches and pains. There's heat, there's things, sensations in your body you can't get away from. So it's like your mind is going on a journey inside your body. Now let's put this very simply. The first thing a fever does, gives you aches and pains, and it makes you want to move. So I always move. So if I've got a fever, you start moving, feel different, go into different postures. Try and alleviate the aches and pains. Do rhythmic movements, pulsing, shaking, wobbling. You do what comes naturally to you. You've got to do these movements. The aches and pains are telling you to move. So movement is key to healing. Remember, a fever is a shamanic healing state, and we're forced into it. But we can learn so much from it. So every time you get sick, every time you get injured, it's a chance to train and learn. And this is why we don't have to make a value judgment on it. So now I'm sick, but I'm treating this as training. And you'll find that actually once the fever subsides, you feel very, very good. You feel like you've cleansed out on the inside. Now, some of you may have noticed that, you know, when you get sick after having a cold or a flu, you still have a period where you feel quite amazing. You've like detoxed yourself. Your body's gone through a healing protocol and you feel good after that. And if you know that now when you enter a fever, you understand straight away, okay, I'm going through a detox protocol. I'm going through a healing protocol. I'm going to feel good. You can start that feeling straight away. You're entering into the world of chi. You're entering in this world into the fever. So enjoy it. Make the most of it. And learn from it. And you're going to get different thoughts and different images coming to you as well. These are the hallucinations in an extreme fever. Oh, just out of notice there, I'm trying that calisthenics on the video. But that is after my surgeries. I've had 4 surgeries, so I could nearly do it. But what's more impressive, I'm trying to do this after 4 major surgeries on my belly. So I've been through a lot. I've healed myself in many different ways. And I basically just see everything as an experience of chi. And if you take it like that, it's much easier to maintain an equanimity. And if you can maintain a calmness and equanimity in the face of all this struggle, you're much better off and you can deal with it much quicker. And I want to just finish by just mentioning a bit about advanced healing technology. You see, The body and the energy in the body is really all about frequencies. It's about vibrations and frequencies. Electricity is moving around, but it's moving around at different frequencies. And this is the way to treat it. So the most advanced medical treatments are going to be based on electromagnetic pulses, frequencies. And all you have to do is measure the frequency of the problem. Let's say the bacteria. Those bacteria will have a particular resonant frequency of their cell membranes. And if you can find it, you have to read it. If you can read that frequency of those bacteria, then you can broadcast a stronger signal back to them, and it will burst them and destroy them. It's exactly like when an opera singer sings the right note, he or she can break a wine glass. It's the resonant frequency. And you can do this with all different types of problems. You've just got to read the resonant frequency, and then you can broadcast it back to counteract it. So this is Star Wars stuff, you know, Star Trek tech. But people are building this, and it's not difficult to do. And if you think about it, a resonant frequency, it could also be sound, and that just takes you all the way back to chanting. You're chanting over the person. This goes back to the shaman. They're chanting over the person as they heal them. They're literally broadcasting a particular frequency to deal with a particular problem. But the shaman reads the problem by intuition, by feeling, and then they make the sound, they chant according to their intuition to fix the problem. And it's not only a chant, it will be a changing chant, a rhythm, a music, a song. They're giving a particular transmission of energy through a resonant frequency or a changing pattern of resonant frequencies. And this is chanting. So you can do this in high technology ways, and we can all do this straight away in our own intuitive healing. And that also brings us back to the fever, because in a fever you often moan and groan. And you let yourself do that and really make the most of it, moaning and groaning. Actually, your body and your energy is instinctively causing you to create resonant frequencies to help you deal with the problem. So in the fever, don't fight it. Go with it. It's telling you what to do. Your body is going into a healing protocol. And it's your soul is going into a healing protocol. Your mind and body are coming together. And we're not used to this altered state, so we think it's not good and we want to fight it. But this altered state is the shamanic journey. You're going into a journey to heal yourself. And if you can face it up front with the warrior spirit, and if you can realize that the ultimate goal is really just harmony and balance anyway. And of course, there's a lot more to this subject. There's a lot more stuff to talk about, and I will talk about this in time. But I hope this gave you something to think about. And of course, we've got to be sensible. We've got to be sensible. Take what we've got. So don't be irresponsible with yourself. Think carefully and listen to all opinions given to you. But there's no harm in getting a second opinion also, a second and third opinion. So thank you very much for listening to me. And I look forward to seeing you in one of these other videos.